people who walked in darkness have seen a great light. Those who lived in a land of deep darkness, on them light has shined. You have multiplied the nation. You have increased its joy. They rejoice before you, for the yoke of their burden and the bar across their shoulders, the rod of their oppressor, you have broken as on the day of Midian. For a child has been born to us, a child given to us.
Pregnant with Christ.
when Jesus' mother Mary had been engaged to Joseph, but before they lived together, she was found to be with child from the Holy Spirit. Her husband Joseph, being a righteous man and unwilling to expose her to public disgrace, planned to dismiss her quietly. But just when he had resolved to do this, an angel of God appeared to him in a dream and said, "Joseph, son of David, do not be afraid to take Mary as your wife, for the child conceived in her is from the Holy Spirit. She will bear a child who you are to name Jesus, for your child will save God's people."
God did not wait till the world was ready, till the nations were at peace. God came when the heavens were unsteady and the prisoners cried out for release. God did not wait for the perfect time. God came when the need was deep and great. God dined with the sinners in all their grime, turned water into wine. God did not wait till the hearts were clear. In joy, God came to the tarnished world of sin and doubt, to a world like ours of anguish, shame. God came and God's light would not go out. God came to a world which did not mesh, to heal the tangles, shield its scorn. In the mystery of the Word made flesh, the maker of the stars were born. We cannot wait till the world is sane to raise our song of joyful voice, for to share our grief, to touch our pain. God came with love. Rejoice, rejoice.
Thank you.
In that region, there were shepherds living in the fields, keeping watch over their flock by night. Then an angel of God stood before them, and the glory of God shone all around them, and they were terrified. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid, for see, I am bringing you news of great joy for all the people. To you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, who is the Messiah. This will be a sign for you. You will find a child wrapped in bands of cloth and lying in a manger." And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly host, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest heaven, and on earth, peace among those whom God favors."
Thank you.
In those days, a decree went out from Emperor Augustus that all the world should be registered. All went to their own towns to be registered. Joseph also went from the town of Nazareth in Galilee to Judea, to the city of David, called Bethlehem, because he was descended from the house and the family of David. He went to be registered with Mary, to whom he was engaged, and who was expecting a child. While they were there, the time came for her to deliver her child, and she gave birth to her firstborn child, wrapped the child in bands of cloth, and laid the child in a manger, because there was no place for them in any inn.
The angels came down from the sky like birds. Their voices were bells. They sounded like flutes. Praise God in heaven. Hallelujah. They came flying out of the sky singing, peace on earth. Hallelujah. Sweet smelling song flowers were scattered everywhere, falling to earth in a golden rain. But scatter these golden flowers. Hallelujah. The flowers were heavy like dew, and the dew was filled with light, shining like jewels in Bethlehem. Hallelujah. Heart flowers, palm like bell flowers, red cup flowers. They're beaming with dawn light. They're shining like gold. Hallelujah. Emeralds, pearls, and red crystals are glowing. They're glistening. It's dawn. Hallelujah. Jewels are spilling in Bethlehem, falling to earth. Hallelujah.
Thank you.
anonymous Argentine poet. They tell me that you came back to be born every Christmas. Man, you are crazy. But maybe, with this stubborn gesture of coming back every Christmas, you are trying to tell us something. That the revolution that all proclaim begins first of all in each one's heart. That it doesn't mean only changing structures, but changing selfishness for love. That means that we have to stop being wolves and returning to being brothers and sisters. That we need to work seriously for individual conversion and social change. That we give to all the possibility of having bread, education, freedom, and dignity. That you have a message that called the gospel, and the church, that is us. A church that wants to be servant to all. A church that knows that because God became human one Christmas, there is no other way to love God but to love all people. If that is the way it is, Jesus, come to my house this Christmas. Come to my country. Come to the world. But first of all, come to my heart.
Christ and with the presence of the Holy Spirit. Amen.